amazing, phenomenal, billionaire woman, Dr. Janae Walker, I got to meet at an event that Savvy Chicks in Real Estate put on. Again, I am collaborative. It takes nothing away from me to share about somebody else's platform. And you guys remember that. When you have friends that are doing businesses, you should support it. Share their stuff. That's bigger than spending $5. Share it. Tell someone else about it. Makeda Smith, she is another phenomenal woman. She has a platform called Savvy Chicks in Real Estate, and she invited me to speak on her panel. So I went into town to Chicago, and I spoke on the panel, and there was this woman. I was like, she is just ravishing. She's glowing. She's amazing. And she wasn't all like, she was very pretty, but she wasn't like, you know, done up. She was real like cash. I was like, oh, what is it about her? So we kept like crash landing. Then she talked to me at the table and she's like, oh, I've heard about what you're doing, this, this, and that. You guys, at the mixer dinner, like the final entourage of the conference, she came in, she was beautiful, okay, flowing. The grace of God had already overcome her before she had even come into the room. I noticed her and I actually reintroduced myself because I didn't realize it was the same person I had just talked to, you know, earlier. She just, the glow, the radiance. Then another colleague, she says to me, she's like, hey, when she speaks, everybody needs to be quiet and listen. Like, you guys, someone's gonna come over you. I was like, okay, we'll see, all right. She got up there, literally, hands down, tears flowing, encouragement. She was the type of speaker, she got off the stage. I was asking people, I was like, how do I sign up with her? Where's her social media? How do I pay her? If you remember, I was at the airport when I was talking to Dr. Janae. I was at the airport, because I had to leave a little bit earlier. I was texting her, inboxing her on Instagram, and I was like, how do I sign up for your mindset coaching? Because mindset was something that I needed to work on as well. Because sometimes we see lag, right? You're just like, how do I get to a different space in a different place? And I'm also not always very easily sold. Again, I want to see somebody that's doing the work. I signed up for her coaching. I had my sessions. So many of them ended in just tears and just thankfulness. I had such a feeling of gratitude. She was the person who taught me about understanding what my name meant. She has an exercise where she asked you, she's like, you're a legendary leader. What does your name mean? My name means God is gracious. As I continue to dig further into what God is gracious means, my name, who I am, literally it says it's a person who invokes change. It's a person that when they're around you, they invoke you to have emotions. They invoke you to have feelings. I didn't even realize that I already had my own ministry because I didn't see it on myself. She was one of the first people that helped me to recognize just what I had built, what I had done, my worth. And I had to bring her here because everybody, every speaker up here has told you about a mentor, a coach, somebody that had an impact on them. And she helped me in my real personal life, and putting her on the stage with me is the least that I could do for a woman that has really just helped me to get my mindset right. So Dr. Janae Walker is our keynote speaker, and she's going to close out our day. We will have our session afterwards, but I have to introduce her this way because she's a very special and just great person. So please help me welcome Dr. Janae Walker.
Looking through your supernatural lenses right now, and you hear me say that Yah himself said that this is the season for black and brown people to take over. You would rise to your feet and begin to lift him up and give him praise. I hear him say that this is your season to begin to tread. Every place that your feet treads, you are taking territory. I see you going back to the States and going to property and going to land and beginning to walk the grounds and opening up your mouth. out than saying, this is my season to take over. I hear the word dominion. It's time for us to dominate in each and every one of our industries and in our domains. Yeah, it's time for us to break generational curses in our families. You are the ones that will change the trajectory of the lives and the money and the finances of the people in your family. You came here to learn about the black print. Yah sent you here to learn about the black print so that you can take over. Amen, amen, amen. I just want to give thanks to Yah, the sovereign, only one and true wise God. And I hear him say, you've been dibbling and dabbling in so many different things and so many different worldly things, but he wants you to give him a try in this season. He is the one who orchestrated this whole event where he put it on each of our hearts to be here on today and converge. Each and every one of you were appointed and assigned to be in this space, in this moment. He gave the vision to the visionary, legendary billionaire, Mrs. Janine Searcy. He put it on her heart to have this entire movement, Black Girls in Real Estate. And she's prophetically aligned with what he is doing in this season because it is our time to break through psychological warfare and psychological chains of slavery. It is our time to break through the spirits of oppression that's been plaguing our people from generation to generation. It's not by happenstance that you are here, because when you look at statistics and you look at data and you wonder why there are not more black people who are wealthy, it's been strategically set up that way from the beginning of time. There's been a target on our backs, but oh, I came to tell you on today that this is your season to take over. You better get that thing in your belly. So I give you honor for giving me the opportunity to come. And your partner, I see so much power with the two of you connecting over there. I see billions in your family and as your legacy. And to all of the powerhouses that came on the stage to impart into you with their parts of the design in the black print, I want you all to give it up for each and every one of those powerhouse women that came to the stage before me and really set the tone for me to culminate everything that was done on today. And I want you all to just stand to your feet one more time and give yourselves a round of applause for making the investment to be here. Yah said that there is going to be a return on your investment, and that he counts every dime that you spent just to be in the room as a seed, and you will see a harvest, because this is good ground. This is good ground. And so there I was in my garage, and I was praying these hot, fervent prayers. If you've heard the scripture that the prayers of the righteous availeth much, or the fervent prayers of the righteous availeth much. I'm like a student of the word, and I like word studies. And so I started looking up fervent and discovered that fervent means hot. If you look really deep in the definitions, you know how it's definition one, definition two, definition three, and you look deeply, it means hot prayers. So sometimes every now and then we're in a rush and we might patty cake with that thing. Lord, I just thank you. No, this wasn't one of those patty cake prayers. This is me going up in the garage speaking in tongues. And I mean, my throat was hurting. I was praying so hard. And as I prayed, I was walking down the aisle in my garage between my old raggedy van and my other car. And I'm going between them, and I'm going in the back, and I'm going in the front. And then I stopped. And as I stopped, I went into this trance. And let me tell you something. Don't be deceived. The witchcraft and some of the wickedness and the occult, they stole from the kingdom. And so trances are biblical, ask Peter, right? And listen, even moving in the spirit from one place to another is biblical. Ask Philip, who was there baptizing somebody, and then the next minute he was gone because he was transported to another location. And so here I am, I'm in this trance, and this trance just renders you in this like out-of-body state for a minute. And I see myself hovering over the entire United States of America, and my eyes were like Google map lenses, and I see the whole outline of the United States of America. And as I'm continuing to pray, there's this black line that is tracing the United States of America, and I call it the black smoky border. And as I prayed and continued to pray, you all, listen, have you all seen those guys that jump out of the planes and their bodies are kind of like, they're like all extended out, right? And so that's how I am, except I'm in this bubble, right? I'm not having any trouble breathing. I'm just looking down. And as I pray, the smoky border around the United States begins to dissipate. And I continue to pray these fervent, hot prayers. And this vision is personal for me. I'm trying to figure out what does this mean. And when this smoky border vanishes, I hear Yah saying that he's enlarging my territory. And now I'm released to go beyond the states. Now I have jurisdiction beyond the borders of the United States of America. And so here I am, 2 years later, speaking in Jamaica. Come on, y'all, give God some praise. And so what is Yah showing you? What are some of the visions that he's giving you for your life and for your business? And what mindset will do is if you struggle with a poverty mindset, the mindset will block your eye gates and prevent you from being able to see yourself wealthy. Somebody said they struggled with seeing themselves owning the entire park, right, trailer park, and what that mindset will do is it will shut down the very vision that God has given you. See, I've been using Janae Walker International for years, and people would laugh when they would call my phone and hear my voicemail and saying, girl, you ain't nowhere but right here in Waycross, Georgia. But let me tell you something else that the world stole from us. Manifesting is a kingdom principle. Do not be deceived. The word of God says, as a man thinks in his heart, so is he, or so he manifests in his life. And I continue to say Janae Walker International until I began to get international clients. And again, here I am in Jamaica speaking to you all today. And so I believe that the black print that Yah gave to Janine is to help us remove the smoky borders from our minds, the limitations that we've had that have held us back, thinking that we can only buy territory in certain areas, that we can never be millionaires and billionaires. He sent me here on today to unlock your minds so that I can unleash the legendary leader that's on the inside of you. He sent me here to tear down the barriers in the recesses of your mind that you didn't even know were there, that were passed down from generation to generation. And please know and understand that only the word of God transforms. You can be motivated, right? But it's the word that transforms. And so I want to take you to Deuteronomy. 11, 10 through 12. Deuteronomy 11, 10 through 12. And so if you all could write that down in your notes. I'm coming from Deuteronomy 11, 10 through 12. And the word says, the land you are entering to take over. Whew, y'all, see, y'all should have been shouting right there. That thing's so good. I said, wait a minute. So the land you are entering to take over is not like the land of Egypt from which you have come, where you planted your seed and irrigated it by foot as in a vegetable garden. But the land you are crossing the Jordan to take possession of is a land of mountains and valleys that drinks rain from heaven. It is a land the Lord your God cares for. The eyes of the Lord your God are continually on it from the beginning of the year to the end. And I believe that Yah is giving us this black print so that we can begin to go in uncharted territory so that we can take over. We're not just purchasing raw land and residential properties and multi-units and commercial properties just to enhance our portfolio. But do you know and understand that when you go into a place that you shift the atmosphere in that place? Do you know when you go into a place that things have to line up and get in order because you are there? He is strategically causing us to be engaged in business ventures and new unheard of acquisitions because he trusts us that when we get to a place that we won't forget that it was the Lord our God who gave us the power to produce all of this wealth. And so why is it important for us to infiltrate all of these areas that we're going into? We already know how it is. We know about the redlining and the strategies to keep us out of places and the secret list and leads that they're producing and hiding from us. We know all about it. But when you take the Spirit of God with you, when I tell you the devil in hell can't stop the move of God, when he says for you to go in and take over, you better go in and take over. He says he wants to take us across the nations, and that's why everybody couldn't come, because everybody doesn't have that international mandate. We expected to see 400 and 500 people, but he says no, there's a legendary few that I can trust to go in even into Jamaica and begin to shift the atmosphere. Some of us began to deal with opposition from the time we woke up this morning. Wardrobe malfunctions, makeup malfunctions, people stealing stuff out of our rooms while we're here to get the impartation. But God says wherever you go, the power of Yah is on the inside of you, and wherever you go, his plans and his purpose for your life will be fulfilled. But not only that, wherever you go, his plans and his purpose for the entire earth will be fulfilled through you. I said, God, I got flued out, and I need to know who these people are, because I got flued out to be here with these people. And he says, these are the ones who will start movements to help the masses. These are the ones who will not be intimidated by the words billions. These are the ones who will lead kingdom takeovers for the kingdom of Yah. And you are the ones whose names he will make great. You are legends. That's who you are. All right, now this technology. So I wanted you to get a visual because I'm a visual learner. And I want us to explore the takeover through the billionaire dimension. I remember when I heard billionaire dimension, it blew my mind. And in the first billionaire movement, we define dimension as the possibility that there's something greater and wider and broader and deeper that exists in an unseen world that we can't even fathom or understand. And that's why I got so much pushback when I started the first billionaire movement, because of the psychological change that as a people we struggle with. They said, this lady must be crazy talking about billionaires. And so it's a dimension. And that's why it's been challenging for us as a people to break through. And so he had me to look at the billionaire dimension as a breaking through. Has anybody ever seen a movie? And when they start talking about dimensions, there's like a wall that's clear, but it may be made like out of water. And you see them step over into that dimension. And there is a realm of a spirit. And you got to be able to understand that with your spiritual mind, that there are dimensions in the earth. And so right now, we currently have 11 black billionaires who have broken through the billionaire dimension. Notice there are only two what? Females, black girls in real estate. I dare you to open your mouth right now and say, I am the first billionaire in my family. And so there are now 11 black billionaires in the United States of America. Out of 742 billionaires, do you see the problem? And in the whole world, there are 2,670 billionaires. And do you see how the black billionaires can fit on the screen? Mind blowing. I wanted you to get another picture here. I wanted you to see this visual so you can understand how important the black print really is. Dominion in every state in the United States of America has been taken by a white male or a few white females. Do you understand when you are in position with that level of wealth that you can make significant changes? You can help people recover from grief all over the world. You can have sanctuaries for people who need to come, Kristen, and just get their lives together for a little while with this level of wealth. I don't want you to think about being rich as filthy anymore. They've used so much propaganda to change our minds about being wealthy. They even lied to the black church and told us that it was a sin to teach prosperity. Why? Because there is a strategic target to keep us off of this map. Come on, come on. And as much as we want to believe that we're so far removed from slavery and that it hasn't done anything to us mentally, I want to challenge you to help you to see that there's probably a residue of the bondage of slavery in the minds of our people, because what else can explain why it's been so challenging for us to break through the billionaire dimension? I've been reading this book right here, Breaking the Chains of Psychological Slavery, and I want to highlight just a little bit of Dr. Nahum Akbar's ideology. During slavery, the slave master's house, with all of his embellishments and his clothes and his manicured lawns and all of the other material toys that were associated with his power, affected the mentality of our people. And it affected us in one or two ways. We associate property and land with the slave master, and we resent ownership and property, and we take an unconscious delight in attacking it. Has anybody ever had a renter in your house and they were black and they went in and tore your stuff up? You all, I was at the pool yesterday just reflecting and relaxing, and this man came and sat next to me, an African-American man, and said that he had some black tenants, and they were tearing his house up. And immediately I went to the psychological chains of slavery. The second thing is this: we have this unnatural attraction to material objects, and we'll spend great wealth that we don't have. and great energy to acquire these objects to look wealthy instead of developing real economic power like Janine is teaching us how to do. And so I don't know if you knew this, but some of the master's things were passed down to some of the slaves, and they would take pride in wearing the master's attire because they looked affluent with a lackluster energy to actually be affluent. But this is the season for us to develop the billionaire mindset, because when we develop the billionaire mindset, we can tear down and abolish and destroy every poverty devil that has come for us in our families and plagued our families from generation to generation. So what are these billionaires doing to amass all of this wealth? I wanted to quickly show you the top 10 ways that billionaires are becoming billionaires. And I want you to screenshot it, because it's gonna blow your mind. I'm gonna show you some first billionaires who are not billionaires yet, but they have been studying the methodology of the billionaires, and they've been making that declaration. And so one of the ways, of course, is investing money, as our sister Nicole has told us, including Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies and NFTs and all of those things. There are 371 billionaires who became billionaires in that industry. And I'm not gonna read all of them, just highlight a couple of them. Number four, create a fashion brand, clothing, makeup, etc. Who is one of the black women on the list that became a billionaire in this domain? Rihanna herself, right? Another one, number six, dominate in the food and beverage industry. There is a white woman by the name of Lindsay Snyder, and she owns In-N-Out Burger. Has anybody ever been to an In-N-Out Burger where the line is always wrapped around? She has a servant mindset. It's important for her to establish that in her business, and all of the people love to work there, and it's been like rated one of the best places to work. That's the food and beverage industry. Another one is diversified. So these people become billionaires in several different ways. So it could be oil and gas and retail and telecommunications. There are 188 billionaires. And then finally, I want to mention number 10. So y'all can screenshot this one. And I'm on there looking cute. And dominate in the media and entertainment. Who is a black billionaire that's dominating in this domain? Tyler Perry. This is his industry. And guess who is trying to come up on his heels? I don't want to steal it, but Kevin Hart, actually. Kevin Hart. Now, he's a ways away from his first billion, but he has a plan. And so all of these billionaires have developed a wealth mindset. And I really think it's important that you all get the wealth mindset, because it's going to help you to break through the lies when they come. Right after you leave these sessions, something is going to happen that's going to make you question whether or not you can do this. And when you have a wealth mindset, it helps you to break through. And so in Unleash the Leader Corporation, we identify leaders as legendary when they exemplify at least six behaviors. When you create your own economy, when you have your own passive income, and when you have a business ecosystem. Have you heard of the word ecosystem? So everybody say ecosystem. When you produce and generate wealth, when you establish a new inclusive economy and create prosperity for all, I want to say that Janine has built a quintessential example of this with black girls in real estate. What has she been trying to help you all? Come on, give it up for her. Give it up. What has she been trying to help you all do? There's this inclusive economy and prosperity for all mindset that she has. When you create opportunities for your people, people to participate in their own wealth journey. And so here's an opportunity for you to get this funding, and then you pay me my fee because it's well worth it, right? And then you can begin to fix and flip your own properties. Build systems collaboratively. And that's why Nicole can rush to the mic and say, listen, when you buy in with her, this is what I'm gonna do for you, because they're working collaboratively. And then you gotta do like me and create a wealth movement. That is what the first billionaire movement is all about. And so I quickly wanna go through three strategic actions, and I'm gonna use three first billionaires to take you through these actions. Now, I want to give a disclaimer, because y'all got to know that I kind of get it from the church, right? Because I'm one of those unorthodox preachers, right? And then I'm like, listen, I promise I heard the Lord. I promise I did. He says that the sons of the world are wiser than the sons of the kingdom. And so I study what they're doing, and I bring it back to the kingdom, because if you look at the chart, obviously you don't see very much representation from those of us who will stand boldly and say that Yeshua is the Son of God, right? And so it's time for us in the kingdom to take over so that we can shift the trajectory of this nation. And so if we go back to the scripture, the first step that I want to give you all is enter into your land to take over. Enter into your land to take over. So whatever your domain is that God has created you to infiltrate, this is the time right now to enter into your land to take over. And so each and every one of us has a domain. We've got a land, we have an industry, we got territory, we have a sphere of influence that God has given us, right? And we all have at least one domain, but multiple domains, right? A domain is an area or a territory that is controlled by a ruler. I want you to say, I am a ruler. Yes, and so the domain, land, and territory has already been established by Yah. You don't even have to try to make up anything. All you have to do is enter in and take it over. We have a responsibility. We cannot leave this place the same. We cannot leave this place doing the same thing, but we've got to leave with the takeover mentality. So take a look at Rick Ross. His net worth right now is about $45 million. I'm just going to highlight a couple of things since you're going to get this PowerPoint presentation. The man has over 25 Wingstop franchises. Have you ever looked into franchising? I think I heard somebody, I think it was Janine, mention the franchise, right? But in addition to what you're doing in real estate, what other things are you having in place to help you to get to the billion? He has books that he's written. He's amassed almost 350 acres of land. Do y'all see that? And so he has a billionaire mindset. Now, his primary domain is the entertainment industry, but as you can see, he's branching off and he's pulling in other industries. So of course you want to have a laser-like focus while you are building your ecosystem from the beginning. If you think about Rihanna built her ecosystem through the music industry. But y'all, we can't make that girl make another CD. All of her fans have been begging and asking. Well, look, she said it did what it needed to do. And so she built her business ecosystem, but now she took that same following and they began to do what? Buy her lingerie and buy her makeup and help her get to her first billion. And so Rick Ross made the declaration. He says, I want to become as large as Elon Musk. And that's all y'all have to do today is make the declaration and go back and use the black print to build your billion-dollar infrastructure. And so he's created multiple ways to earn streams of income in several domains. So he has the black print for the takeover. Come on, come on.
When I heard the word where God said, it's not like the land of Egypt from which you've came, because some of you might be a little intimidated. Do not expect this move for you to be like everything else that you've done. God says he's doing a new thing. But what I'm really excited about is he's going to give you an anointing of ease. It doesn't mean that you're not going to put in work. It doesn't mean that the work isn't hard. But when you do it, it's going to be easy. Don't compare it to the land that you had or the properties that you already established or acquired. But God says he is doing a new thing. And in this land that you're going into, he's nurturing it and he's caring for it from the beginning of the year to the end of the year. My God. My God. Now the next step is you got to go through it to get to it. Anybody other than me been going through some things in your life? I know we have the luxury brands, but some of us have luxury brands and our bank accounts aren't really aligned with the luxury brands. But I want to encourage you that he's teaching us something in this process, and we got to go through something to get to the amazing thing that he has for us. And so you may be going through something in your life right now that seems impossible, but he says it's not impossible, but it's process. And you can't take over if you stay stuck and stagnant where you are. And so when you go back, it's got to be different. Let's look at Kevin Hart real quick. At one point, I thought it was over for Kevin because he got involved in a scandal. Do you all remember that? And there was this video circulating about him, and I'm thinking, Lord, Lord, I'm praying for him behind the scenes, and I'm like, Lord, help him, because this is a mess. And it was his mindset that enabled him to break through that scandal and get to the other side, because he has a billionaire mindset. You all, I call it resilience. Anybody like been through hell in your life? We already know one person that's been on the stage that has been through hell in her life. Anybody else pressing through the hell that you've been through in your life? Because you know that it's something on the inside of you that you gotta birth out. No matter how much you try to fight it or run or hide, it's pulling you and pushing you from the inside, because you've got to do it. Kevin Hart has resilience. And so he went through the scandal and the ridicule, but he decided that he was going to dominate. So you can kind of see, have you seen his movies on Netflix? So I'm sure that that is a lucrative contract between him and Netflix. And so he's ventured now into movies from just stand-up comedy. So he's also building his ecosystem, and he has a billionaire mindset. If you just keep going, if you just keep pressing, you will cross over on dry land, but you gotta push. Somebody say push. And the last person I want to share, y'all know this beauty? Yes. That from down in Georgia? Yes. Your last point is you've got to own it. You got to own it. But the land you are crossing the Jordan to take possession of, that's your charge, to take possession of. You got to claim it right now. It doesn't matter what the bank account looks like, you all. It doesn't matter what your situation at home looks like. I prophesy that when you go home, things that were out of order are going to be in order, because the word says that God will go before you and make the what? Crooked places straight. You can literally take possession of the land in the spiritual realm. I dare you to see that dimension that I described and reach through that dimension and take possession of the land in your mind first, and watch God begin to line things up for you. You got to get comfortable succeeding. You got to get comfortable winning. You got to get comfortable prospering, because this is your season to take over. And so Pinky Cole entered into her new land. She's taking over and possessing the land. She owns her new domain. She didn't care what anybody else was doing in the food and beverage industry. She said, I'm going to go into this thing and with my vegan restaurant, and I'm going to take over my way. And what she has done is she scaled her business to $100 million. And so now she's getting ready to expand her reach by adding 5 more chains in different states. She has a what? A billionaire mindset. She's building her ecosystem. And so after she created this amazing food brand, have y'all seen the latest? Pinky Cone now has a vegan sneaker using vegan leather. Now you would think that doesn't make any sense. It doesn't have to. Whatever he puts on your heart to do, that's what you do. She's just gonna take over. And she's made the declaration, I am the first billionaire in my family. And so the last mindset I want to share with you is the dominion mindset. And I want to let you know it's not optional. This is a mandate that he gave us in Genesis chapter 1, verses 26 through 28. He said, let them have dominion. But then he said, no, have dominion. And so we're supposed to literally be in the earth taking dominion. He never created us as a people to struggle. Do you hear what I'm telling you? You got to wonder why does all this stuff happen to us as a people? I dare you to get it in your belly right now that you are the chosen people, that you are a special race of people. What other explanation is it for us to have this constant target on our backs? And when you have a dominion mindset, you're like, I'm taking over. The mobile home queen, right? I'm taking over territory. I'm pioneering something that nobody else has done, like Pinky Cole. I'm dominating in my position, like Janine Searcy. I'm being set apart in my domain, like Janae Walker. I don't worry about who else does mindset coaching. I'm just focused on my lane that he gave me, and that's how you gotta be. You don't look to the left, you don't look to the right, none of that matters. You do what he told you to do, you get in your zone, and you dominate. And then you wanna have more ownership. You're not satisfied with the 5 properties that you have in your portfolio. You want more. And y'all, let me just throw this in there. Bill Gates is stealthily buying up all the farmland. Are y'all paying attention? Do you look at the land report that lists the top 100 landowners in the United States of America? And Bill Gates is so sneaky that he's been buying up the farmland using other DBAs to buy up the farmland, but we're on to what he's doing. And so why is it that he's buying up farmland? Like, what is going on around farmland? I just want to encourage you to go ahead and get you a plot of land for farming. They're doing something, y'all, when I tell you. They are doing something. Now the gas prices are going up and the food prices are going up and something's going on with the chickens. All you got to do is Google it and look it up. The chicken prices went up and all of these oxen were slaughtered and killed and nobody knows how. And some of the largest food manufacturers in the United States of America are mysteriously getting burned down. We're not going to be depending on a system to feed us when we came from sharecroppers. We know how to farm the land. This is our season to do what? Take over. You got to be expanding your reach and gaining ground and gaining influence. And so I want to challenge you. I remember when Janine, one of her sessions, Janine was getting ready to continue her tour. And God told me to tell her that as you're going into these different states, that you need to pray and ask him, what are the principalities in these areas that you just can't bust up in a state and teach people how to become wealthy and teach our people how to become wealthy without some type of retaliation. And so you gotta make sure that God has given you access to go into these territories with your movement. And listen, you all. She had her states all mapped out, and I know she began to do exactly what I told her to do, which was pray. And so I want to challenge you. Where are you going to establish your restaurant chains? Where are you going to erect your shelters? Where are you going to buy more real estate? Billionaire Larry Ellison has real estate in every corner of the map of the United States. Think he's not strategic? You got to beware of stuff that's going on. I think Bill Gates is also going to Arizona and building a smart city. Pay attention to things that's going on, even the propaganda. And so I want to challenge you all. I want you to map out your dominion. When you leave here, where are you getting your mobile homes? Where are you buying your Airbnbs, right? Where are you going to have your rental properties? Where are you going to have all of your properties? Because you have to have a dominion mindset in order to take over. I heard somebody say something about a saturated market. But listen, I heard God say that this is your season to subdue the earth and control the market. It doesn't matter how saturated a market is. When you go in with the favor of God on your life, you can control the market. This is when you become a category king. When people think of billionaires and mindset and leadership, they think of Dr. Jhené Walker. When people think of fixes and flips and real estate, they think of Mrs. Janine Searcy. When people think of the mobile home market, they think of the lady that was right here. When people think of construction, they think of the lady right here. What comes to mind when people think about you? Are liens and taxes your niche? When you have a dominion mindset, you dominate the market, but you also dominate the economy. They say that billionaire coach, she taking up all the money. That fix and flip girl, she buying up all the houses and fixing them. You've got to become an expert in your domain. See, that's what builds up the confidence. When you study your craft, when you read, when you research, when you know everything that's going on real estate in Arizona, that's when you begin to build up your confidence. You need to become the problem solver in your niche. You need to be the one that companies call on in order to solve big problems for them. And so you are uniquely and wonderfully made, and nobody can do what you do better than you can do it. This is your season to take over. I dare you to stand to your feet right now and receive this blessing over your businesses and ministries. If some of you all are in ministry, I declare over you right now that your personal economy will be blessed, that you are no longer reliant on the world system for your economy, but you are a wealth producer. You will not experience any lack or scarcity or poverty in your family anymore. We cover your clients, your current clients, and your clients that are on the way. Your impact is secured. Your influence is secured. Your territory has just been enlarged. Your sphere of influence is in the nations, and you will begin to make bold and courageous decisions that will set you up to take over. Thank you so much.
Y'all see why my mind says different? Look who I align myself with. I just told you I paid her for coaching. Those are the type of women, these women are here today. This is who is supposed to be pouring into you. Get people that are gonna pray over you, hug you, tell you they love you, be in your corner, support you, cheer for you. I'm so passionate about this. Y'all have got to win. The lack has to go. We cannot keep surviving like this. We can't. I have had every walk of life up here. They're just like y'all. What's the difference? The mindset and the opportunity to take a risk on yourself. You got to step into your dominion, your niche, your passion. We talked about many different things today. That is why I call it the black print. Dr. Janae crashed it over the head. There's so many different areas of opportunity where you could get great. Pick one. Pick one. Invest in it. Read in it. Come to class. Do everything you could possibly do to get great. It is the confidence that sells. I already had failure, and now I'm winning. My business is winning. My business is flourishing. Why not? This is for y'all too. This is not just for us. We are here because we are committed to your excellence. And I need y'all to match us and commit back to us. Please, for the love of God, do not leave here and not use what you just learned. Only 1% of people that attend conferences, classes, use it. I can't believe it. It's like, why would you spend the hours? Don't even come. I'd rather not see you come. But you're in this room today, which means you want it. You want to win. You want the knowledge. You want to be great. You're already great. It's just finding where you're going to go and spread it. So I have to tell all of you amazing ladies, all of you guys I consider friends, family, I just love you so much. I'm so grateful to come into a business, a whole niche, to know no one. Look at what this has created. If I'm not the perfect example of chasing your dreams, I don't know what is. I'm telling y'all, this was built from laying in bed at night and adding people and asking people to be my friend and putting the work in. Y'all can do this too. I'm so proud of all of you. I'm proud to see all of you guys win. I pray for y'all all the time. This is life. This is a lifestyle. Winning is a lifestyle. You can get very accustomed to losing. Every day waking up, damn, every day, ugh, another blow back. At some point, you have to, again, what did I say? Choose yourself. Choose you. You don't have to help those family members that ask you for money every single time. I have a half rule. And then, what did it shrink down to, baby? $99. You need help. Oh, if I could just get $99. It's the same people, right? That energy drains us, people that call that are negative, people that bring you drama. I surround myself with people that drive solutions. People that uplift, creative, solution. I'm a very authentic person. I thrive off of loyalty. It's a huge thing with me because I am very loyal. That is the thing for me. Find those type of friends. We're all here. I picked my speakers because they're my friends. I like them. They're great, and I want to put them on stage. But I also know they're going to treat y'all like sisters and brothers. They're not going to walk off of here, walk out the room, and you come up to them, and they're not going to speak to you. That's not this type of event. I'm putting people in the room that do the work, have done the work, and are committed to you. So when you leave here, what have y'all heard me keep saying? I inboxed them. I spoke to them. I reached out. Do that. Please don't leave here without talking to people amongst yourselves, figuring out what people are doing. Make your connections. This is the time. Don't leave here without getting at least, I challenge you right now, 3 new numbers from people you never met. Just random people at the conference that you have built a connection with. I challenge you to that. Find 3. Okay? Make your connections, build your business, stay plugged in. And more than anything, as I always say, thank you guys for being a part of Black Girls in Real Estate. Again, Irene, thank you for being my platinum sponsor. Couldn't have done this without you guys. Abacus CPA has been amazing to me. I'm grateful to all of you guys. Thank you for making the time, the investment, and the commitment to be here. I love all of you, and I say that with all my heart. I hope you see that. And just thank you.